Former Senator Antonio Trillanes files another case against a Duterte, this time against Congressman Paulo Duterte, over a huge shipment of illegal drugs. Our very own Adrian Ayalin on the line now with details. Adrian, over to you.
Yes, Carmina, Davao City First District Representative Paulo Duterte, former Bureau of Customs Commissioner Nicanor Paeldon, Vice Presidential Husband Attorney Mance Capio, and others are facing a complaint here at the Department of Justice in connection with the seizure of 6.4 billion peso smuggled shabu in 2017. In the complaint affidavit filed by former Senator Antonio Trillanes, the three respondents, including Nilo Abellera Jr., Pompey Perez, Alan Capuyan, Charlie Tan, Teofilo Joseph Bakud, Neil Anthony Estrella, Nani Cabato Coronacion, also known as Tita Nani, committed conspiracy in the smuggling of 600 kilos of shabu. Trillanes based his complaint on the committee report of the Senate Blue Ribbon Committee, which conducted hearings on the incident. Trillanes recalled in the complaint that on May 17, 2017, the shabu shipment from China, which arrived at the Manila International Container Port, was approved for release through the Green Lane or Express Lane, which requires no further screening such as X-ray. Trillanes cited the testimony of customs broker Mark Ruben Taguba that Duterte and Carpio, who are supposedly members of the Davao Group, only needed to call BOC collector Jet Maronilla to facilitate the clearance of the container. While Don supposedly influenced fellow respondents Estrella and Bakud to break the chain of custody and facilitate previous shipments of Taguba. Trillanes urged the DOJ to initiate a preliminary investigation and the subsequent filing of charges of violation of Republic Act No. 9165 or the Comprehensive Dangerous Drugs Act of 2002 against all respondents. Also, Carmina, for Duterte, Carpio Abellera, Capuyan, Espelia, Akud, and Faldon, Trillanes said they should also be charged with violation of Republic Act No. 3019 or the Anti-Graft and Corrupt Practices Act. Meantime, Carmina, in the interview with Trillanes with the media here at the DOJ after the filing, he has simplified the supposed conspiracy and he said that Charlie Tan is the supposed drug lord while Duterte, Mance, Carpio are the so-called protectors and Faldon and the other BOC people are the facilitators. Carmina?
Right. Did the senator, the former senator Adrian, make any mention as to why only now? I mean, we remember that hearing, right? It was in the news cycles for days on end. But why the filing of charges only now, Adrian?
Yes. It was also asked by the media in his ambush interview. And Trillanes said that it is actually more than 7 years after the 2017 incident. Why is he filing the complaint just now? He said that, of course, the situation before was different when the Dutertes were in power, although he clarified that the judiciary has been fair all along, but except in cases involving the Dutertes. Carmina?
All right, Adrian Ayalin there joining us on the line. Thanks, Adrian. Philippine National Police once again defending its move to reduce Vice President Sara Duterte's security detail. Raya Capulong reports.
The Philippine National Police insisted on the need for additional forces in Metro Manila, which is why the police security detail of Vice President Sara Duterte was reduced. Furthermore, the PNP declined to comment and even PNP Chief General Romel Francisco Marbil refused to address the issues raised by the Vice President in her open letter to Marbil. However, PNP spokesperson Colonel Jean Fajardo clarified that this is part of the reorganization of the former presidential security group. The security unit of the vice president was placed under the newly formed presidential security command.
Inabsorb na po yon ng PSP yung unit po na yon, and as a result of that ay nakipag-ugnayan po mismo yung director po ng PSPG sa opisina po ng vice president at para ipaalam po sa kanila kung maaari ay magbawas po ng personnel po ang PNP dahil mahigit 100 po ang nakadetail po doon sa na-create po na Vice Presidential Security Protection Group. At nagkaroon naman po ng understanding na ipu-pull out po itong 75 po at may maiiwan po na 30 plus doon po sa OBP na maliban pa po ito doon sa component po ng Armed Forces of the Philippines.
Fajardo also denied what Duterte stated in her open letter that policemen were sent to where she lives for surveillance.
According to our PNP leadership po ay wala pong katotohanan po ito. But then again, sabi nga natin, whatever issues po na nakapaloob po doon sa sulat po ng ating pangalawang pangulo, ay ang PNP naman po ay bukas sa anumang pong dialogo at anumang pong pwede pong magawa para i-address po itong mga concern po na ito.
Fajardo appeals not to involve the PNP in any political issue. Senator Aimee Marcos is requesting for the return of Duterte's police security detail in the soonest possible time. She emphasized that the security of Duterte cannot be compromised, given her position as the second highest elected official and allegedly as a target of the CPP-NPA. VP Sara, on the other hand, thanked the senators and others who supported her, including AFP, PNP personnel, and ordinary citizens who volunteered to help provide her security. Raya Capulong, ABS-CBN News.
An ally of former President Rodrigo Duterte slams the office of the Solicitor General for saying it will not stop the International Criminal Court from interviewing persons of interest in the bloody drug war. Solicitor General Menardo Guevara earlier confirmed the ICC has requested to interview five individuals as part of its drug war probe. But Attorney Salvador Panelo says allowing the ICC's request is contradictory to President Marcos' stance. The international body has no jurisdiction over the country. Panelo also urging Marcos to get a hold of his officials, whom he says are pulling the president down.